of Let's Talk About the Music. This show is dedicated to Jamie Hartley, a strong young woman with a lovely voice and a big heart. Jamie suffered from epidermolysis bullosa, or EB, an inherited disorder that causes the skin to be extremely fragile, like butterflies' wings. Hear the story of Jamie Hartley live Wednesday, March 30th from 8 p.m. to midnight Pacific Standard Time at letstalkaboutthemusic.com.
Live in studio on April 26, 2016. We're going local, everybody. Seattle's very own Johnny Sonic. That's right, guys. Johnny Sonic's going to be on the air with me, your host. We're going to talk about politics, music, and his charity coming up right here. Let's talk about the music on April 26th. Don't want to miss it. Seattle's very own Johnny Sonic.
I've been dark, I've been distant, living deep inside my head. And if I surface, eyes adjust, bumble forward out of bed. I've been too long holding judgments from the corner of myself. Accept no visitation. You can navigate this well. Mm-hmm. Oh, this well. Sanctuary. Trying to break through all the stone. You're the pole against my anchor, the only light that brings me. Oh, oh, oh. You're the calm against my bluster, the stubborn stranglehold. You're the ever-present ladder.
Slow Cheddar, Sanctuary, they're from Ohio. And tonight we have Mike from MusicSUBMIT.com. His Skype was breaking up, so he called in instead. And so we're going to try.
Sounding better?
Yeah, you're saying a lot better. So let's go back to what we were talking about before you break up and had to take a little commercial. Now, when musician sends me, how many other blogs, websites that you actually send? You said you send about 500 people a month?
Yeah, no, well, for the artists, we have a couple hundred different artists that we send every month, but in our total number of stations and blogs across all the genres, we have about 5,000.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, there's quite a bit. There's a lot. But, you know, like rock and pop and hip-hop and country, there's, in the 800 range of different stations and sites. And then jazz, it goes down like maybe 600, 500. And then it goes down, you know, maybe for New Age, we only have 200, or classical, we only have 100, something like that.
Okay. You know, and before, again, before you broke up, you now do they send you CDs, or is it all through the websites, all MP3s? How does that work?
Oh, yeah, that's right. You don't have to send CDs. You can just go to the website, MusicSUBMIT.com, and create an artist account. It's free to do that. You can go in there. You don't have to pay for it or anything. You just go in there, create an account, upload your songs, pics, bio, press release, whatever you have, and you basically create a music press kit. And most artists that are familiar with, like, Reverb Nation, I was saying, is another site. Music X-Ray, Sonic Bids, they all have press kits that they send out to different contacts. And so ours sort of looks like that. It's a player with songs in it, and then pics and some information, and then links to all your social media sites.
Cool. Fantastic. And I like it that they have a Facebook, because when I do my playlist, I'm able to link their webpage to, hey, this is who I'm playing. If you guys go to my Facebook page, you see, and I have a WordPress group along with it, it shows everybody's playlist, and it's actually see who's playing, where they're from, and what song I'm playing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Facebook's good for that. Every artist is pretty much has Facebook now, and there's all kinds of other sites, too. Twitter and Instagram and SoundCloud and all of those. So,
yeah.
You know, there's only so much time. You can't know some bands say, which one should I be on? All of them? Like, well, I usually say pick 4 or 5 social media sites that you think you can maintain real well. And that's good. You don't have to be on 10 different sites.
Yeah. I think the few musicians I've been getting that they have no social media whatsoever, and I can't not find them.
Right. That's the pain, too. If you don't have enough and you Google, you look for their band name, and maybe they have a not-so-distinguishing band name. And anyway, it makes it difficult. So the more sites you're on, the better. And have a unique band name, too.
Yeah, very sure. And now, I don't even know how to ask you, because I don't really know. It's the first time actually doing all this stuff, I'm just trying to tap into side independent musicians who wants their music out there, and to speak with you, get on radio stations, but they just know how to do it. Have you had any success stories on any musicians who's been on your site and has gone to the A-list or no longer independent and stuff like that?
We've done a lot of bands over the years. We've been around since 2005. And so, yeah, we're in our 11th year, and we've done, a lot of indie bands. Artists always ask that, too. Who have you made successful? Who's, like, really popped out of, broke out and is super spectrum? The answer to that, really, Kacey Musgraves is an early artist of ours. I don't know if that rings a bell, but she won a Grammy for Best New Album, or maybe Best New Artist. Everyone thought Taylor Swift was going to get it that year. It was a couple of years ago. And anyway, we would like to think that some of the promo we did for her when she was 17 years old helped her get to the next step after that. And after that, and finally when she was 25, she actually won. So anyway, I know there's a lot of people involved with getting it all to that, but we'll take some credit for it.
Okay, that's it. I mean, my success story happened to be Spire in the Hall. I got him from you guys, so you can add this to your story. Spartan the Hall, he submitted your guys' music. I found him. I love him. And now he and I are really good friends. And he is now, he's done my theme
awesome.
Song. Huh?
That's awesome.
Yeah. He did a theme song, and he also did an instrumental one. So every time we have a promo that we do, and we have no idea what kind of music we're going to play, we play his instrumental music, and so his music is in the background. So Spartan Hall is your new success story.
No, that's great. I love hearing about those. You don't often hear. I mean, we can tell in our system when which bands are doing well. In terms of getting approves from the stations and the sites, which ones are responding to the music and so forth.
Really?
But you know what? Yeah. Like if we send you out to a band to 400 different places, we can see that you were accepted by 35 and rejected by 21 or something like that. So that's pretty good. But of those 35 places that, you know, so we're going to do airplay, we're going to do reviews and what that led to. We step out of the picture. We don't take, we don't share in your success. We just, you know, we just do our thing and get you your airplay and reviews. And it's really, it's mostly on the band how far they go after that.
Yeah, I do really have to do, it's basically the band's responsibility to be the most awesome band out there or a single artist out there to actually get their music heard. I know that inside they're doing the most fantastic job out there and getting their music out there, but sometimes it's just not enough. They got to keep going at it. And a few topics ago, people didn't realize that being a musician is hard work. They all think it's an addictive or a hobby.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and it's not. It's actually hard work.
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's a very expensive hobby, actually. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, when you start, you play and put a band together, you're solo artist or whatever, it's a lot of dedication, and the money's not going to come right away. You could be waiting a long time. If you know, a lot of artists, some of the really good ones, it's really not about the money at all. It's about making your art. So,
oh yeah, it's all about
but
the music.
We always like to, you know, that's right. It's all about the music. You can have that forever.
Mm-hmm. You're going to say something, and I cut you off. I didn't mean to. What were you just going to say?
No, that's all right. I was rambling on there. I was drifting off into. I think I finished it up.
Okay, we're gonna go back to the music. Be right back with more of Mike. If you guys have any questions about to Mike and independent music or smit.com, you can give me a call here at 360-464-4216. If you're following me on speaker, you can also chat with me in the chat room. It's wide open. Be right back. And by the way, Mike, this is Spider in the Hall. This is brand new music, and I'm telling Spider he needs to submit this to bigger stations because his song is going to go big. He's not listening to me. You guys, I'm telling you. It's a deal with the devil. It's an awesome song.
All right, cool. We'll talk about that.
Okay.
And when we're back.
Got it.